5 miles from Limerick in the romantic west of Southern Ireland, there was trouble in an unusual form. Grave discontent among 700 Hungarian refugees accommodated there in an army camp by the ERA government. Many of them went on a hunger strike in protest against not being allowed to go to Canada or the States. They did not call it off till several were seriously ill. Irish army doctors attended them. The government sent an official from Dublin to tell them it was not Ireland's fault they couldn't go. Meanwhile, the children at any rate are making the best of things, trying to learn the language under a Hungarian teacher who speaks English. The arrival of the Irish Red Cross, with letters from home, is the bright spot of the refugees' existence. These unfortunate victims of Red tyranny were told in Austria, soon after they escaped, they would be allowed to cross the Atlantic. And though the children seem happy enough, their elders believe they were purposely being kept behind. Idle life at camp has nourished their grievance. They're afraid that years of dreary hut life lie ahead. As far as America goes, not till the states modify immigration laws will Hungarians in any number be admitted. But on the very first plane flying from London on the Canadian emigration airlift, more than half the seats were given to refugees. Hundreds have been taken since. Canada has lowered the normal restrictions in their favor. May all who so wish be able to cross the Atlantic before long.